Hello everyone, my name is Deeksha Jain and I have secured rank 22 in CSE 2018. In this video, I will be talking about chapter number 9 of Economic Survey titled Enable Inclusive Growth Through Affordable, Reliable and Sustainable Energy. So, this chapter starts with a quote from Rig Veda that sun is the soul of all animate and inanimate. So, what it basically means is that the emphasis of energy is now moving towards solar, and this quote is sort of an evidence of that. So in the beginning of the chapter, we'll talk about certain facts associated with the energy scenario of India. So the first thing is that despite accounting for 18% of world's population, India uses only around 6% of the world's primary energy. So energy poverty has been pervasive in India. Number two is that with an increase in per capita energy consumption by 2.5 times, India will be able to increase its real per capita GDP by $5,000. This is according to 2010 prices. So basically, if we are able to increase the per capita energy consumption, our economy will also grow. Number three is that energy efficiency programs have been very successful, basically resulted in savings worth more than ₹50,000 crores and a reduction of about 110 million tons of CO2 emissions in 2017-18. And lastly, that while the share of renewables in total generation has increased from 6% to 10% in 2018-19, India still needs investment in renewable energy to promote this sector. Currently, the market, one more associated fact is that the market share of electric cars is only 0.06% while compared to China's 2%. So this is also an area which we need to work on. So this chapter will be talking about energy for prosperity, energy poverty, energy efficiency, as well as a detailed bit about the scenario of electric vehicles in India and what needs to be done. So let us first talk about energy for prosperity. So India cannot become an upper middle income country without either rapidly raising its share of global energy consumption commensurate with the share in the global population, or also ensuring that universal access to modern energy is available to everybody. India's energy intensity has actually declined at a much lower level of GDP than it did for other developed countries when they started declining. So if we increase our energy usage, then it has a lot of potential of economic growth as well as social equitability. The Sustainable Development Goal number 7, which deals with clean energy, is closely associated with the other SDGs. So Human Development Index also will increase if the studies have shown that Human Development Index is also closely associated with the access to energy. So basically, energy access is a very important component of economic and social development. So the next thing that we will be talking about is energy poverty. So, first thing is that there is a wide urban-rural divide in terms of energy poverty. For example, the LPG usage in urban areas has caught up massively with more than 90%, while in rural areas, it is still not that. It is not at par with the urban areas. And energy poverty is also said to be wider than income poverty, which basically means that even though, supposing that in the lower income strata also, people of the on the higher income side, it does not mean that they've started using better energy. It basically means that even people in the higher strata, in rural areas especially, they are still not using LPG. So that energy poverty is wider than income poverty refers to this. So, and also as we all have read in the newspaper, that government has made many initiatives like Ujwala scheme, Pehel scheme, to overcome this energy poverty so that everybody has access to clean and healthy energy like LPG. Now we'll talk about the energy efficiency programs. So the energy intensity of India's GDP has been falling lately, which is basically a good indicator that our energy efficiency is increasing. The term energy efficiency basically means that we are using lesser amount of energy to get the same amount of output. The institutional legal framework for energy efficiency comes from the Energy Conservation Act in 2001, under which the Bureau of Energy Efficiency was created. The overall size of the energy efficiency market in India is $22.81 billion. So it is a huge market and India is tapping it, relatively successfully. So there are some energy sector specific energy efficiency schemes which are there in the table. So I won't be going into them in detail, but they are available in the table in the slide. So another important fact about this is that the contribution in energy efficiency is largely from three major schemes, and they are PAT, which is Perform, Achieve and Trade for Industries, Ujala scheme, under which all the CFLs and normal lights have been changed into LEDs for energy efficiency, and the standard and labeling, which is basically that all the companies are labeling their products with energy efficiency so that they also have a greater obligation to make their products energy efficient, and the consumer is also conscious about using more energy efficient products. The overall energy savings due to energy efficiency measures have been 7.21% of the overall energy consumption. And lastly, the industrial sector has the greatest potential for energy efficiency. So that is where we are looking in the future for energy efficiency market as well as measures. Now we'll talk about the sustainability of energy generation. The mix of India is that almost 60% of India's energy is coming from thermal power, out of which the main component is coal-based energy sources, energy thermal plants. Under Paris Agreement, we have committed that 40% of our installed capacity will be changed to renewable by 2030. Considering that renewable power is intermittent and there is not proper storage facility for renewable power, it is important to also keep thermal power in the loop. We cannot just let go of thermal power suddenly. And we will also have a lot of non-functioning assets if we do that. So there is a need to also make cleaner and more efficient coal technologies, so that whatever coal power that we are getting, it becomes clean. Finally, the economic survey says we need a comprehensive energy policy which takes into account both the economies of coal as well as renewable sector. So basically, it calls for a comprehensive policy on energy. Now, the next thing that we are going to talk about is the potential of renewable energy in India. So budget 2018 and 19 announced zero import duties on components used in making solar panels to give a boost to the domestic solar sector. Apart from that, many financial incentive schemes have been initiated to promote the use of solar panels and to promote the use of solar energy in domestic processes, industrial processes, as well as even in agriculture as well. So now globally, India stands as 4th in wind power, 5th in solar power, and 5th in total renewable power of installed capacity. Our cumulative renewable power installed has increased from 35 gigawatts in 2014 to 78 gigawatts in 2019. So that is also that we are doing reasonably well in this sector. Other interesting things that have happened in the sector are that viability of renewable has improved with falling tariffs. There has been a considerable improvement in technology in the sector as well. Kusum Yojana has been also promoting farmers to adopt solar panels and to de-dieselize the agricultural sector. Hydro has a potential, but because of high tariffs, so that is also, we are trying to rationalize that as well. So basically, renewable energy sector seems to be growing at a very high speed now, and it is an area that we should look out for in the near future. Another very important component is vehicles and electric vehicles at that. In India, the transport sector is the second largest emitter of CO2, and 90% of this emission comes from the road transport. So because of that, electric vehicles become a huge way in which we can reduce this. And internationally also, e-vehicles are being promoted in all countries. We have also committed that we will also change all our vehicles to e-vehicles in the coming times. With this view, the National Electric Mobility Mission Plan 2020 was launched. And then FAME India scheme was further launched to fast-track the goals of the NEMMP with an outlay of 795 crores. Apart from this, states are also taking initiatives. For example, Telangana has targeted 100% electric buses for intra-city, intercity and interstate transport in its state, in its state transport corporation. So states are also taking many initiatives. Another thing which is not unique, but it is something, an important consideration, is that electric vehicle market in India is dominated by two-wheelers. So we can tap this market even more by improving the technology in two-wheelers. UP topped among the states with highest sales of EVs in India. The market share of electric vehicles has been increasing with increasing availability. However, there are two major impediments to the e-vehicle sector. Number one is the lack of charging infrastructure, and number two, the long time that is taken to charge a vehicle. Even fast chargers take around 1 hour 45 minutes to charge a vehicle, so that is too long. we need to focus on improving technology to for fast charging as well. Now we'll also talk about the solutions to this. The economic survey advises that we should come up with universal charging standard for the country as a whole. We should also enable increased investment in the creation of such infrastructure from the private sector as well. Work on improved battery technologies that can function appropriately at even high temperature conditions. And if we take care of all these things, and especially the charging infrastructure, India can not only adopt e-vehicles and improve its environmental emission standards, but it can become a hub of e-vehicles manufacturing and consumption. So that can give a boost to the Indian economy. So that was that about this chapter in the economic survey. Thank you so much.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.